You're the king of these people. You're the lord of this nation. You are. You're the light in this darkness. You're the hope to the hopeless. You're the peace to the restless. You are. There is no one like our God. There is no one like our God. For greater things have yet to come, and greater things are still to be done in this city.
Come set your rule and reign in our hearts again. Increase in us, we pray. Unveil why we're made.
come to set our hearts ablaze with hope, like wildfire in our very souls. Holy Spirit, come invade us now. We are your church, we need your power in us. We seek your kingdom first, we hunger and we thirst, refuse to waste our lives, for you're our joy and prize. To see the captive hearts released, the hurt, the sick, the poor at peace, we lay down our lives for heaven's cause. We are your church, we pray, revive this earth. Build your kingdom here, let the darkness fear. Show your mighty hand, heal our streets and land. Set your church on fire, win this nation back. Change the atmosphere, build your kingdom.
No! in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never zoom on the enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army.
Yes, sir.
I'm in the Lord's army.
Yes, sir.
I'm in the Lord's army.
Yes, sir.
I may never march in the infantry, but I'm in the Lord's army.
Yes, sir.
I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never zoom on the enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army.
Yes, sir.
I'm in the Lord's army.
Yes, sir.
I'm in the Lord's army.
Yes, sir.
I may never march in the infantry, but I'm in the Lord's army.
Yes, sir.
I may never march in the infantry, ride in the cavalry, shoot the artillery. I may never zoom on the enemy, but I'm in the Lord's army.
Hello and welcome to this Sunday's service for All Saints Church, Dedworth. It's a good morning from myself and Lily Dog. We'd like to welcome you all here today. Please do get in contact with us this week if you need to. Details about how you can do that will be appearing on the screen throughout the service. Also, do remember to join us for tea and coffee after the service. You can do that via Zoom. Again, you should see those details now and later on during the service. Today we're going to be hearing from Rev Roy about Stir Up Sunday, and then with prayers from Carolyn. Let's just start with a prayer. Dear Father, please bless all of us today as we hear about Stir Up Sunday. Please bless us all and bring us all closer to you through our relationships that we embark with you, whether we're starting new or we're exploring more. Please look after our congregation as they watch this online video service. Bring us all your love and glory. Amen. And now, over to Nikki with the family news.
Good morning and welcome to Family News this week. So, our first item today, have a look at this. This is from Kira. Can you see what word she spelt? It says hope. Hope in studded leaves. This is from the service from last week. I think it's absolutely amazing. And the best bit is, Kira, if you eat that, you have at least three of your five a day. And look at this hope picture that was sent in from Erin and Penny. We just seem to be food fantastic this time. Now, this section came about from Christine off of the church WhatsApp group. And, you know, I'm really, really strange and odd, as you all know. And Christine was talking about old favourite toys. And I thought, let's do pictures of our favourite teddies that we would take on a teddy bear's picnic. And I've had some really wonderful pictures. I didn't think it would take off, but I've had some amazing photos come through. So I'm going to start off with my teddies. Just hang on a second. So my first one I would choose to take on my teddy bear picnic is my Spot the Dog. Spot the Dog is 37 years old. Look, he's looking good for his age. See? Now, I used to have him in bed with me when I was little, and now my Alfie snuggles up in bed with him. And my second one is my Care Bear elephant called Tenderheart, and he's also 37 years old, and he continues to remain in my bed, snuggled up with me at night. Now, as Christine thought of this idea, we're going to put Christine's photos up first. And this is Blue Ted, and it's her son's teddy bear, and he'll be 48 on February next year. And if you look closely, you'll see that this is a picture of Christine with her father's hat on. Doesn't she look really cute in that photo? And here is Ruth and her sister Anne. Ruth is holding her doll called Sally Ann, and Anne has her teddy bear called Ted Woo Bear. This is Penny's teddy bear called Mick, who is 64 years old. Penny says that she loved and still loves Mick to bits, and he went everywhere with her, including all of her hospital visits. Here is Jackie Wiggins holding her dolly, also called Sally Ann, and Ducky. Jackie cut Sally Ann's hair quite drastically when she was 3 years old, so she always has to wear a hat now. And Ducky used to love playing in the puddles in the lane outside her house. Sally Ann is 68 and Ducky is 71. Here is Carolyn and her brother Ant. Carolyn looks very pleased with her umbrella there. It will come in very handy if it rains at our teddy bear's picnic. And Ant is holding a frog hand puppet. Mike Brooks is holding his favourite teddy bear, who is also the same age as Mike. So that makes them both 50 in a few weeks' time. This is Mary Findlay's Kanga and Roo babies in Mum's pocket, and this was a 20th birthday present from her college flatmates. And next to Kanga is this doll, and it was actually her grandma's from about 1820, and it's still in its original dress. I think that this definitely wins the prize for the oldest doll at the picnic. Here is a picture of Adam's bunny, which he has had since a baby, so approximately about 33 years old. Adam said that the bunny went everywhere with him, and now Khalees also has a similar bunny to Adam, which she now treasures above all our other teddies. Thank you so much for sharing these pictures with us. They really made me smile when I saw them come through. You know, and as though we're not together to have a picnic, we've just had a virtual teddy bear picnic together. And finally, we have a big celebration. It is Mike and Christina's 23rd anniversary today. Look at this picture, which was taken on their wedding day. Christina, you look absolutely beautiful. Not so sure about the man with the dodgy tash though, eh, Mike? Thank you so much for everybody that's contributed today, all of the family news. We can't be together, but we can share our blessings. Keep sending them in. So today, Stir Up Sunday. So guess what I'm going to ask for you next week? I would like to see pictures of you cooking your Christmas cakes and your Christmas puddings ready for Christmas time. God bless and see you next week.
It's a great day to praise the Lord. It's a great day to praise the Lord. It's a great day. Praise the Lord, walking in the light of God. It's
So walk, 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 walk in the light. Walk, 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 walk in the light. Walk, 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 walk in the light. Walking in the light of God. It's a great day to praise the Lord. It's a great day to praise the Lord. It's a great day to praise the Lord. Jumping in the light of God. So jump, 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 jump in the light. Jump, 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 jump in the light. Jump, 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 jump in the light. Jumping in the light of God. Well, it's a great day to praise the Lord. It's a great day to praise the Lord. It's a great day to praise the Lord. Hopping in the light of God. So hop, 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 hop in the light. Hop, 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 hop in the light. Hop, 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 hop in the light. Hopping in the light of God. Well, it's a great day to praise the Lord. It's a great day to praise the Lord. It's a great day to praise the Lord. Sliding in the light of God. So slide, 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 slide in the light. Slide, 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 slide in the light. Slide, 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 slide in the light. Sliding in the light of God. It's a great day to praise the Lord. It's a great day to praise the Lord. It's a great day to praise the Lord. Walking in the light of God. So walk, 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 walk in the light. Walk, 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 walk in the light. Walk, 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 walk in the light. Walking in the light of God. So walk, 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 walk in the light. Jump, 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 jump in the light. Hop, 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 hop in the light. Sliding in the light of God. Walking in the light of God. Walking in the light of God.
Praises rising, eyes are turning to you. We turn to you. Hope is stirring, hearts are yearning for you. We long for when we see you, we find strength to face the day. And in your presence, all our fears are washed away. Washed away.
Come have your way among us.
yesterday, and in your presence all our fears are washed away. When we see is when we see you, we find strength to face the day. And in your presence all our fears are washed away, washed away.
The Bible reading today comes from Matthew chapter 25, verse 31 to 46. The sheep and the goats. When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit on his glorious throne. All the nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate the people from one another, as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. He will put the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, "Come, you who are blessed by my Father, take your inheritance, the kingdom prepared for you since the creation of the world. For I was hungry and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger and you invited me in. I needed clothes and you clothed me. I was ill and you looked after me. I was in prison and you came to visit me." Then the righteous will answer him, "Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you a stranger and invite you in, or needing clothes and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and go to visit you?" The king will reply, "Truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me." Then he will say to those on his left, "Depart from me, you who are cursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry and you gave me nothing to eat. I was thirsty and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger and you did not invite me in. I needed clothes and you did not clothe me. I was ill and in prison and you did not look after me." They also will answer, "Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or needing clothes or ill in prison and did not help you?" He will reply, "Truly I tell you, whatever you did not do for one of the least of these, you did not do for me." Then they will go away to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Hi, it's lovely to be here again, and this is a very special Sunday. It's a Sunday that says it's Christ the King, and it's also a Sunday called Stir Up Sunday, and we'll think a little bit more about those in a minute. But first, before I begin, we're going to listen to a piece of music which is from The Crucifixion by Stainer, and it talks about the King who is ever glorious.
King ever glorious, the supremest splendor, but in weakness and surrender, thou hangest here. Zion dwelling, Rome with arms the world compelling, proud though they be. Thou art sublime, thou art sublime.
So let's start by talking, first of all, about Stir Up Sunday. A lot of people over the years have called this Stir Up Sunday, and they thought it was about Christmas puddings. Now, I don't know if you've ever stirred up a Christmas pudding, but in the old days, what they used to do, and this is my Christmas pudding, only it's a mince pie, because a Christmas pudding's a bit big, okay? Now, what they used to do in Christmas puddings in days gone by, they'd stir it up, and when they stirred it up, in the middle, they'd put a sixpenny piece, which is worth about 2.5p nowadays, and they would put it in the middle of the Christmas pudding, and when the Christmas pudding was cut, what would happen is that the person who won the took the piece that got the sixpence in, had that, and they kept it. I think that was pretty dangerous, because I know somebody who choked on one of those, but basically what they used to do, they'd take their sixpenny piece, represented here by a tenpenny piece, and what they'd do is they'd blow it away, and it would be completely gone. But what they would do is they would find it in their Christmas pudding. So, you've taken it, there it is. The children would get really excited, But what would happen is they'd blow it away, and lo and behold, there's another one in my mince pie. So, stir up Sunday. It's all about stirring up Christmas puddings. No, it's not. Some years ago, people used to use, and they still do now in some churches, the collect from the Book of Common Prayer. And I have the words here. It says, "Stir up, we beseech you, O Lord, the wills of thy faithful people." In other words, this is the Sunday we're preparing for Advent, and we're getting ready by stirring up our will to prepare ourselves for the coming of Jesus. And Jesus is Christ our King. And that piece of music that we've heard just now about King Everglorious is an amazing piece of music to me, because it starts with Christ as if he's present at the moment, King Everglorious. But then it takes us deep into his crucifixion and the pain and the suffering and all those needs that he went through. Just imagine, he died there, stabbed, bleeding, pained, just for us. And yet, that wasn't the end of the story, because he rose. He was the King who was ever glorious, Jesus Christ, our King, who is now the King of Heaven, in that place where one day we will be reunited. And let's remember that as we celebrate today Christ the King. I don't know if you're ready for Christmas. It's going to be a strange Christmas this year. We don't know if we're going to be able to meet our families. But some people are already putting up Christmas trees, putting up the decorations. If you walk through the streets, there are a lot of houses already decorated. They are preparing. They're preparing for a celebration. But they're not all celebrating the same thing that us as Christians do, because we celebrate the coming of Christ. And that's what Advent means, the coming of Jesus at this time of year. It's very special to us because not only does Advent mean the coming of Christ at Christmas as that little baby, but it also means about us preparing for the second coming of Jesus. One of the things that is so important to me is holding on to that hope for the future that Jesus will come back into our lives. We don't know how, we don't know when. It may be at the end of this service, it may be in 100 years' time. We don't know. What I do know is that that promise that Jesus made to us will come true, because everything that Jesus promises is right. And we need to prepare ourselves in our hearts, in our minds, for what lies ahead. And that's why Christ the King, this Sunday, is preparing our hearts to remember that person who was born at the end of that first Advent that we're talking about, as a baby, lying on wood, that bare wood of a crib, wrapped in very old clothes and things, because that's probably all they could afford. And he died lying on wood, wrapped in some old bits of cloth. The beginning and the end were both the same for Jesus in a way. And yet, through all this, we have hope. It's about stirring ourselves to move forward into what lies ahead. Not just his birth, not just his death, his resurrection or his ascension, but the fact that he is now in heaven, the King of Heaven. Now, there's some strange words in that gospel reading that we have today. One of them says that Jesus Christ is going to cast us into eternal fire if we be naughty. And the other bit says that he's going to be sitting on the throne of judgment. Now, I don't know what you think, and I'm not quite sure what I think. In my mind, I don't see Jesus casting people into the fire. I don't see Jesus sitting on a throne as we would know it. Although he's King of Heaven. What I do see is Jesus putting all those things of judgment in a very better order than some people do. The kings of old, if we went back to the kings in Jerusalem in Jesus' time, they were cruel, vindictive people whose only thing was to punish people as soon as they could. Jesus puts punishment back, and what he does is he brings forward our good deeds. And so what he looks at first when we stand before him in judgment is, what have we done in this world that follows what he has preached and what we as Christians can do. And what can we do? Well, during this time of COVID, I know there are a lot of things that we can do. My wife and I, actually this week, were out buying things that we could give to a charity that is now being prepared by the local church. Our church in East Hampstead has now got a new thing that goes alongside the food bank. And so we've been giving them goodies that can be then distributed to families in our area. There are people who are lonely. One of the things that I do at the moment is I telephone people regularly. I have a long list, which is so long. And every one of those is a person that I phone, and I'm trying to find out how to use Zoom. I can go to Zoom if somebody invites me, but I don't know how to host it yet. So one of these days, my Advent journey, my learning, is going to be learning how to use the Zoom so I can actually use it to help other people. So this Advent, do your preparation. Let your preparation be, first of all, let it be prayer. Underpin everything you do with prayer. That's so vital to us because that is our strong base from which we live. We remember the coming of Jesus. And Jesus said things like, in that gospel reading, when I was poor, when I was starving, when I was naked, you were there for me. When I was in prison, you were there for me. In our world today, and especially today with all that's going on with this virus around, so many people are lonely, so many people are hungry, in need. There are families where children can't be fed. We need to think of the ways that we can help. And my request to you is that when this service is over, perhaps you and friends or family could think of the ways that you could reach out to other people. You are preparing to welcome Christ because you are doing the things that Christ would have asked of us. Not to be selfish people, not to be people that are isolated from the rest of the world, but people who care about the rest of the world and care about those people who've got the things that we haven't. So may this Advent be a very special time of year for you. May you remember Christ, our King, as he sits in glory in heaven, in that place where one day you, me and everyone will be reunited. And remember when we get to that gate of heaven, the question that Jesus will be wanting to know of us is, what have we done to help others? May God bless you in all that you do. And on this Stir Up Sunday, may your wills, may your passion, your love for Jesus mean that you can take that out into the world, remembering the two things that Jesus taught us, which were the New Testament version of the Ten Commandments. Love God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul. And love each other. I finish by remembering a Christmas carol. In the bleak midwinter, what can I give him? That's the end, last couple of lines. What can I give him, poor as I am? I can't give the lamb, I can't give the frankincense and gold and myrrh. What can I give him, poor as I am? If I were a shepherd, I would give a lamb. If I were a rich man, I would play my part. But what I can, what I have, I give him. Give my heart. Amen.
Oh, what a foretaste of glory. Let's pray together. Father God, we thank you that we can come so freely to you right now to bring you those things that are on our hearts. Thank you that you always hear us when we pray in faith. And we ask that you'd increase our faith and that you teach us to pray. We ask that you'd fill us with your love and help us to realise how much we have been given so that we could go to the lost, the least and the broken, bringing your love, hope and healing. We pray for the nations of the world at this time, and we ask you for an end to this pandemic, that you would guide leaders and give them your heavenly wisdom as they navigate this crisis. We pray for your Holy Spirit to move in the hearts of many and turn people towards Jesus, the hope of the world. We pray that you will revive your church, that she will become the city on a hill that you've created her to be. Thank you that you are a great redeemer, and we pray that out of this difficult time, a new compassion and understanding for each other will arise. We pray that you'd strengthen communities and improve relations between families and nations, and you would comfort all who mourn the loss of loved ones or the loss of livelihoods. We also pray for those we know at this time, and we lift them to you today in prayer. Vanessa's mum Sue, Oliver, Colin, Jess, Laura and Andy, Jane and her family, Amy and Jackie. So let's hold before God those we have on our hearts this morning in a moment of stillness. Lord Jesus, we pray for your presence to surround all those we've named and remembered in our hearts. We pray that you'll bless them with your healing and your peace and with the comfort that comes from the Holy Spirit. We thank you for your goodness, your mercy, and the everlasting arms. Thank you for the health workers and volunteers who've served so tirelessly through this year. And we pray for your blessing and protection on them, that you would provide for them the energy that they need. We pray that you would continue to guide all who work at the West Windsor Hub as they help the local community. And we ask that this work would touch people's hearts and lives with your love. Thank you that you came, Lord Jesus, to show us how deeply loved we are by the Father. And thank you that you gave us your Spirit to teach us and lead us, and that you are praying for us right now. We're sorry for the things we've done that have hurt you, and the things we haven't done. And we turn to you and ask for your forgiveness. Thank you that your mercies are new every morning, and that you died so that we could live as new creations in you, and that nothing could separate us from your love. Thank you for the blessings that you've poured out on our lives, for our families and friends, and for the beautiful world that you've made that speaks about you every day. We're sorry for the damage we've done to your creation, and we ask for your help to right wrongs and to do things better so that resources are shared and the environment is protected. We pray for those parts of the world where there is persecution, war or famine or exploitation, and we pray for your justice and peace to come. Show us how we too can work for peace. Father God, we offer all these prayers up to you in the name of your Son, Jesus. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Hello, I'm Sue, and it's my turn to bring you the notices this week. You should be receiving your copy of our latest newsletter around now, which gives you all the details on what's going on at All Saints Dedworth. We're doing our very best to keep in touch with you during this latest lockdown and share some of the upcoming events for you to take part in. Although, of course, all these plans are provisional at the moment and subject to COVID rules. We're looking forward to a different Christmas this year, and there's lots of opportunities for you to be creative and join us as we celebrate by telling the story of the birth of Jesus, God's Son. Look out for our special YouTube services and our Zoom Bible studies and meetings, and the special fun activities on offer for our children and young people. This week's newsletter is on our website for you to enjoy. And look out for tonight's youth gathering on Zoom for 11-year-olds and upwards. Have a great time this week.
Thank you everybody for tuning in to watch the service this week at All Saints Church. It's really appreciated. And thank you for all of the good words we heard from Roy and Carolyn's prayers today and Nikki's family news. We hope you enjoyed this week about Stir Up Sunday, and I hope it stirred up something in you. Please remember to stay in touch with the church this week. You can do so via the website, email, Facebook, or even leave a comment on YouTube. Details to join us for the family tea and coffee after the service should be showing up on the screen shortly. So we'd love it if you could all come along and join us. And now we'll finish with a prayer. Dear Father, please remember to continue your support throughout this week. Please keep us working closely together with your love, patience, kindness in our local community. Please look after all those who are finding times difficult at this moment in lockdown. Please remember and remind us all that we are all here to support one another. Let's go out this week with love and peace in our community and with our friends and family. Amen.
Now I can see it. The clouds are clear and everyone hears it. The sound of hope, freedom is rising. Your glory is falling and the lost are returning home. There will be seen.
Creation will crown you, Lord. Let peace fill the shore. King is coming, coming. The King is coming, coming. The King is coming.